amagambo nshaka kubigisha ajyanye na theme muriho muri iki gihe.
So the word I want to teach you that is in line with the theme you have.
Ni ijambo ryo mu Bakorinto ba mbere 6:17.
Is the word that is found in 1 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 17.
Haravuga ngo uwifatanya n'umwami Yesu ababaye umwuka umwe nawe.
On verse 17, the Bible says that whoever is united with the Lord is one with him in spirit. We receive the grace to be saved. And that gave us the blessing to be united to the Lord Jesus. Try to imagine about all the benefits, all the good consequences of uniting with the Lord Jesus. Try to think yourself as a mason building some stables or other places for animals like rabbits.
Noneho agasohoka itangazo ko ugiye kwifatanya na Roko cyangwa Horizon, izo ni kampani zikomeye zubaka.
And then there comes an announcement that says that you're going to unite yourself or join with Roko or Horizon. Those are big companies in construction here.
Kandi kubwo bufatanye butazavaho.
And that partnership or union is never going to end.
Kandi kunyungu za Roko na Horizon zose zibaye izawe.
And that you're going to share in all the profit of Roko and Horizon.
Ariko bakaguha condition.
But they give you one condition for that?
Kuko aribo bafite experience na expertise na n'amafaranga.
Because they have expertise, they have the funds, they have experience.
Nibo bafite abatechnicien, nibo bafite ibyo ukeneye byose.
They are the ones who have qualified technicians, they are the ones who have every resource you need.
Weho urasabwa ko uzabumvira bakakuyobora.
You just need to obey them and they are going to lead you.
Noneho inyungu mukazisangira.
And then you share the profit.
Uwifatanya n'umwami Yesu ababaye umwuka umwe nawe.
So whoever unites with the Lord becomes one spirit with him.
Tekereza ngo mwifatanyije.
Now try to imagine or reflect about that one you have united with.
Ni ufite amakuru yose.
He is the one who has all the information.
Ni ufite ubushobozi bwose.
He has all the power.
Ubwenge.
All the wisdom.
Amafaranga.
All the money.
Imbaraga.
All the power.
Ubugingo buhoraho.
Eternal life.
Byose arabifite.
He has all that.
Condition.
Just one condition.
Igihande cyo kumvira kiri mu mwanya wawe.
Obedience is on your side. That's your responsibility.
Utabyemeye ntacyakora.
When you don't accept that, it's not going to do anything.
Njya kubanza mbere kakadarama gato kamara nk'iminota itanu.
I just want to give you an illustration of a drama that
kuko
is for like 5 minutes.
Kumva no kureba nibyo bigira umumaro kurusha kumva gusa.
Because hearing and seeing is more important than just hearing.
Niho radio itandukaniye na televiziyo.
That's the difference between radio and television.
Ano rero nariteganyirije.
So here I'm blessed because I have some of my students here.
So
Eddie is my student. Please come first.
Abandi banyeshuri wanjye Harriet banguka.
Harriet, come first.
Norman ni umwarimu nabanguke.
Norman is a teacher, so please
Harriet,
come.
Yes, Claudia nawe ngwino.
Claudia, come also.
Aba barahagije.
These ones they are enough.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Murabareba.
Can see them. Please come here.
Imana ikurema.
When God created you,
yakuremye uri ubutatu.
He created you in three, like with three dimensions.
Mm-hmm.
You were in three dimensions at
Muhinduranye.
Creation.
Ngwino hano gato. Uri umubiri, uri umutima, uri n'umwuka.
You are the body, you are the soul, you are the spirit.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Cor, ame, esprit.
Body, soul, and spirit. That is you.
Umugabo.
The man.
Umugore.
The woman.
Umukozi wo mu rugo.
And the servant or the domestic servant.
Ahera, ahera.
The holy of holies.
Ahera.
The holy place.
N'inyuma mu rugo.
And the courtyard.
Umuhondo w'igiritetse mu mazi.
The yolk.
Umweru w'igiritetse mu mazi.
The white of the egg.
N'igishishwa.
And the shell.
Umwuka,
the spirit,
ubugingo,
the soul,
n'umubiri,
and the body.
Agire uwihuta nzanira agatebe aho ngaho.
Someone comes first with a chair.
Amen. Yesu aguha umugisha, agutanze ingororano kuko agize vuba.
He gets a reward first because he's been fast.
Icyaha rero cyaraje.
Now sin comes.
Birumvikana ko umwuka w'Imana niwe wagombaga kuyobora.
And the spirit was supposed to take the lead.
N'ubundi umuhondo w'igi ni uryoha cyane.
You know the yolk of the egg is more nutritious.
Kandi umugabo niwe uyobora agahamabwiriza umugore.
And the husband is the one who gives instructions to the wife.
Wenda ibyo nabanishe kuri gender issues aho
ngaho. Just ignore anything about the gender issues.
Noneho umwuka waturutse ku Mana yagombaga kuyobora.
Now the spirit that came from God was supposed to take the lead.
And the
Bible says that be led by the spirit.
Nuko rero icyaha cyaraje kica wa mwuka.
Now the sin came and it killed that spirit.
Nuko mwuka arapfa.
And the spirit died.
Icyaha cyishe umwuka.
The sin killed the spirit.
Ubwo kugushyikirana n'Imana birapfa.
Now the relationship, the communion with God was killed. Because God is a spirit.
Gushyikirana nayo mu mwuka.
And we need to commune or fellowship with
Him in the spirit. Umutima n'umubiri.
Now there was left the soul and the body.
Hasigaye umuhondo w'igi n'umusore umweru w'igi n'igishishwa.
The white and the shell.
Hano harimo ubwenge.
Here there is intelligence.
Nuko rero umuntu umeze gutya ubwenge bwe nibwo bumuyobora.
Now the man who is like this, he's led by his wisdom.
Ariko hano harimo n'ubushake.
There is also the will. For you to take every decision, you need to choose that. It's a decision. It also means that for obedience, the intelligence or the will has to be aligned to agree. You have that ability to obey. After the spirit died, the soul and the body, they made a partnership.
Kamere.
That is called the flesh.
Kamere.
The flesh.
Mutima wa kamere.
The soul of the flesh. The body of sin.
Iyi kamere ni iyoboye
isi. And this is the flesh that is leading the world.
Kandi niyo yakuyoboye utarakizwa.
And it is the one that has been leading you before you receive Jesus.
Hanyuma inkuru nziza yaje.
Now the good news came.
Ubwirwa ibyanditswe.
You heard the scriptures.
Ubwirwa ibyo Yesu yakoze ku musaraba.
You were told about what Jesus did on the cross.
Ukibibwirwa.
And after hearing that,
ibyo ni ijambo.
That is the word.
Umwuka wera araza.
The Holy Spirit came.
Umwuka wera aje kuko wumvise ijambo.
The Holy Spirit came after you heard the word.
Azura wa mwuka wawe.
And he raised your spirit that was dead.
Nuko wongera kuba muzima.
And then you became alive again.
Wongera kuba sensitive ku bintu by'Imana.
You became sensitive to the things of God again.
Nuko rero umaze gukizwa.
Now after receiving salvation.
Muri wowe havutse irindi shyirahamwe.
There was another partnership that was born in you.
Wifatanyije n'umwami Yesu.
You associated or united with the Lord Jesus.
Abakorinto ba mbere 6:17.
First Corinthians 6:17.
Wifatanyije n'umwami Yesu.
Whoever unites with the Lord. He becomes one spirit with him.
And
because Jesus is a spirit, he's no longer in this physical body. So you can't join or unite with him physically. But because he's a spirit, and because you have a spirit that is alive again, you unite with Jesus spiritually. That is the example I gave you. This was a mason building small houses for rabbits and chicken. And then he unites with a strong company like Rock and Horizon. And the profit of one becomes the profit of the other. He has everything. Jesus knows everything, he's everywhere and he's almighty. And that's what shows divinity. The fact that he is God. He brings to you the all knowledge, the all might and the all presence. And he's the one who has to take the lead.
Technically,
he's the one who knows everything. He knows your future.
Azi imigambi agufitiye nibyo worship team yaririmbye.
He knows the plan he has for you. That's what the worship team sang.
Yateguye imirimo uzagenderamo.
And he has prepared works for you to walk in.
Abefeso 2 haravuga ngo kuko turabo yaremye.
In Ephesians 2 it says we are the ones he created.
Aturemeye imirimo myiza iyo yateguye kera ngo tuzayigenderemo.
Created for the good works that he prepared in advance for us to walk in.
Ariko uyibuka ikibazo gihari.
But you need to remember the problem that is there. The will is found here. And this is the soul or the flesh.
hatabyemeye.
And if here doesn't align with the spirit, the spirit is not going to do anything.
Umutima wawe utabyemeye.
If your heart doesn't allow, accept.
Ubushobozi bwose bwa Yesu ntacyo buzakumarira.
All the power and might of Jesus is not going to be of any use.
Umutima wawe utabyemeye.
If your heart doesn't accept or align.
Amafaranga yose ya Yesu nta nubwo azayaguha kuko wayangiza.
All the money Jesus has is not going to give you because you're going to waste it.
Umutima wawe utabyemeye.
When your heart doesn't accept,
wisdom yose ya Yesu, urukundo rwose, ibyo agufitiye byose,
all the wisdom of Jesus, his love, everything he has for you,
ntacyo bizakumarira.
It will be of no use,
kuko hano niho hafungura,
because this is the part that has the key.
Niyo mpamvu ijambo ry'Imana rivuga mu migani,
and that's why the Bible says in Proverbs,
ngo mwana wanjye,
say my son,
umutima wawe.
Give me your heart.
Mwana wanjye.
My son.
Mpumutima wawe.
Give me your heart.
Udahaye umutima wawe Yesu.
If you don't give your heart to Jesus.
Process yose yo kukugira umwigishwa.
All the process of transforming you into a disciple.
Ntabwo izagera ku ntego.
It's not going to be successful.
Umukristo umeze gutya umutima we ari uwa kamere.
A Christian who is like this, who has the heart of the flesh.
Ariko yaravutse ubwa kabiri.
But who's been born again?
Yitwa umukristo wa kamere.
He's called a Christian of a carnal nature.
Ntabwo ari umukristo w'umwuka.
They are not a spiritual Christian of the spirit.
Ubwo rero.
So.
Kukuru wa kamere,
because you're of the flesh,
uzakora ibya kamere kandi waravutse ubwa kabiri.
You're going to be to do the deeds of the flesh, yet you're born again.
Ariko uko ibya kamere bituba ku bwami bw'Imana.
But because the works of the flesh do not build up the kingdom of God,
imirimo yawe,
all your works,
nk'umukirisitu,
as a Christian,
ntabwo Imana izayemera.
God is not going to take them into consideration.
Ubu barimo kubaka convention center.
While they are building the convention center,
ntabwo wajyanayo rukarakara cyangwa ibiti.
You know, you can't take mud bricks and take them there.
Nawe ugiye kubaka Rwanda.
Some wood.
Ntabwo wakubaka ubwami bw'Imana.
You won't say you're going to build Rwanda. You can't build the kingdom of God.
Utaregurira umutima wawe Yesu.
If you haven't dedicated your heart to Jesus.
Kuko amabwiriza yo kubaka ubwami.
Because the instructions of building the kingdom comes from that side.
Uyu niwe ufite plan yo kubaka Omega Ministry.
He's the one who has the plan to build Omega Ministry.
Uyu niwe ufite plan yo kubaka ubwami bw'Imana ku isi.
He's the one who has the plan of building the kingdom of God here on earth.
None arakwemereye ngo yikonektinge nawe.
And he has allowed you to unite or join with him.
Uwifatanyije n'umwami Yesu ababaye umwuka umwe nawe.
Whoever unites with the Lord Jesus becomes one spirit with him.
Ubwo rero bizasaba iki?
Now what is required?
Bizasaba ko nyuma yo kuzura uno mwuka warupfuye.
What will be required is that after raising this spirit that was dead, he was dead, now he's risen again.
Namwe yarabazuye abari bapfuye muzizi bicumuro n'ibyaha byanyu byo mwagenderagamo iyo Ephesians.
He has raised you who were dead by your sins and transgressions in which you used to walk in, that is Ephesians.
Nyuma yo kukuzura,
now after raising you up,
harakurikiraho urugamba rwo kujya kubohora uyu mutima.
There is the battle of setting the heart free.
Kuko uyu mutima,
because if the heart is not set free, you're going to be a young and small Christian who is called of the flesh or the carnal nature. That's how the Corinthians were. And Paul told them that I gave you milk. Now we say Gigo's first formula, first aid formula. You'll still be on first age formula for 15 years, yet you are here in Omega Church.
Ntago rero umuntu uri kuri iyo regime ntacyo azakora.
So someone who is on that diet is not going to do much.
N'ingororano z'imirimo ntazazabona.
Even the rewards of what he has done is he's not going to get.
Twitegure rero urwo rugamba noneho Yesu agiye gushora rwo kubohora uyu mutima.
Now let us get ready for the fight, the battle that Jesus is going to engage. Of set his heart free. The first thing Jesus does is he strengthens the spirit. in the spirit. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter
3
that be strengthened in your inner man.
Yes, inner man,
we might say inner person nowadays. That means in the spirit. Yes, you have to be strengthened in your inner person. Because there are two partnerships or two associations. There is the heart of the flesh that is joining with the body of sin. And there is your spirit that is united with the spirit of Jesus. Because whoever unites with the Lord Jesus is one spirit with him. So now for this part to be strengthened and to God deliver that heart, or set free that heart, this part needs to be fed. This part needs to be fed. I'm going to tell you about 5 sorts of food. 4 or 5 depends. Let me tell you. Do you know malnutrition? When a child doesn't eat enough, like in quantity.
Yes.
They get malnutrition, they look dry. Those kids in Darfur, you can see them, they're so skinny, you can even count their bones. They eat very little. That's how it is even in wars. But the children who are there in the village, long time ago when we still lived there, I'm not sure how it is today. Those who have malnutrition, they are eating one sort of food only.
At 8, they eat sweet potato, 10 sweet potato,
midday sweet potato, 2,
then
6, they're eating sweet potato. They will have malnutrition, but they will look big. They look big. They have enema. They look big, but they're sick. We find that in church. So the first thing for this part to be strengthened, because
Matayo,
it has to eat, that is Matthew. Man shall not live on bread alone, but they will eat, live on every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. So first of all, word is your food. That is If you eat food, but if you eat the word, but in small quantity, you're going to have that kind of malnutrition that makes you look skinny. Of course, you hear the word in the service, but when you're home, when do you get time to feed on the word of God? If you live only on what you get here on Sunday and Wednesday, then you have malnutrition. Try to imagine if here you were feeding people physically and they eat only on Wednesday and Sunday and they have to live on that only. Try to imagine if here they were giving you food, real food, and that is what they give you. You have to take whether you have malnutrition or, because you don't eat enough, you eat small quantities. Hopefully that's not how it is. So the first food is the word. Jesus told the Samaritan woman, that is John chapter 4, he said, if you knew the one you're talking to, you ask him for living water. You ask him for water and he will give you living water. And after that, later on, Jesus explained that that water he talked about, he was referring to the Holy Spirit. That food is communion with the Holy Spirit. And you obey him. And you learn to know about him. How many times do you feed on that kind of food?
yoboraga niyo ministry yabo kutujyana mu mwuka no gusabana n'umwuka.
The worship team was leading us in their ministry, that is to take us to commune with the Holy Spirit.
Ibyo ngibyo worship team ikora ibikora ku cyumweru gusa no kuwa gatatu.
The worship team does it on Wednesday and Sundays.
Ikindi gihe nawe sujya ugirira umwanya wo kurya kuri ibyo biryo.
Do you also get some time to eat on that kind of food?
Niba ucungira ku byo ku cyumweru gusa no kuwa gatatu.
If you really rely on Wednesday and Sunday food on you need to ask yourself if you have malnutrition that will make you look skinny.
Yes, adufash.
God help us.
Ariko ibyo nabyo ni ibiryo.
But that is also some kind of food.
Mwuka wera yaraje.
The Holy Spirit has come.
Kenshi dusabana nawe mu kumwumvira, dusabana nawe mu gusenga.
We commune with him through obedience in prayer.
Amasengesho usenga namwe y'iri torero bashyize kuri gahunda.
Do you only pray according to the church schedule only, or you also have your personal times of prayer? You need to tick if you're being fed in this aspect. And while talking to the Samaritan woman, Jesus said in John 4, after she had gone back, the disciples had been shopping to some stores.
Nuko baramubwira ngo niyakire arye.
And they told him, here is the food, you can eat.
Nuko arababwira ati, mfite ibyo kurya mutazi.
And Jesus told them, I have another kind of food that you know nothing of.
Nuko urangiza umurimo no uyantumye.
That is finishing the work of the one who has sent me.
Gukora imirimo y'Imana ni ibiryo by'umwuka.
Doing the works of God is spiritual food.
Impamvu umwuka wawe yazutse ni ukugira ngo ukore imirimo y'umwuka.
The reason why your spirit was brought back to life is for you to do the spiritual works.
Nkaba mfite ikibazo.
And now I have a question for you.
Ukora iki?
What do you do?
Ukorera iki ubwami?
What do you do for the kingdom?
Ukora iki muri iri torero no hanze yacu?
What do you do in this church and outside this church?
Kubirebana n'ubwami.
For the kingdom.
Kuko niba warakijijwe.
Because if you're born again,
uri urugingo.
You're a member on one part.
Torero ni ingingo za Kristo.
As a church, we are parts of the body of Christ.
Kandi Kristo ni umutwe.
And Christ is the head of the body.
Nta rugingo rw'umubiri rudafite umumaro.
There is no single part of the body that is not useful.
Ubu ndababwiriza.
Now I'm preaching to you.
Amaguru yanjye niyagendesha.
But my legs are walking.
Maso yanjye arabareba.
And my eyes are looking at you.
N'ikiganza cyanjye kiratanga mezi.
And my hand is doing some gestures.
Uku kuboko kwataye umudendezo wako.
This hand has lost its freedom.
Kugira ngo microphone ngumye nyikoreshe.
So that I might continue to use this microphone.
Ntago wakorera Imana utemeye gutakaza imwe mu
You can't serve God without accepting to lose some of your freedoms. But it's not only that. I'm standing here because my heart is beating properly. And because my lungs are breathing like they should. That one you can see with the eyes. It means there's some parts that are, can be seen. There are other parts that are working behind the scenes. The members that can be seen, the pastor that can be seen is the pastor, the worship team, those people we see. But what about you? What do you do as a member or a part that can't be seen?
I'm
standing here because I'm healthy, I don't have diabetes, my pancreas is doing what it's supposed to do.
Ariko nta muntu urambwira ngo ngufite urwagashya rwiza. Bambwira ko mfite mu maso heza gusa.
You know, people have never told me that my pancreas works or looks fine. They just tell me that I look okay.
Kuko amaso aragaragara ariko urwagashya ntirugaragara.
Because you can see the eyes but you can't see the pancreas.
Ariko Yesu yaravuze ngo gukora umurimo nka urangiza n'ibyo kurya.
But Jesus said that completing the work of the one who sent me, that is my food.
Nk'urugingo rero ukora ufite ibyo ugomba gukora.
Now as a part of the body, you have something you're supposed to do.
N'ibirenge byanjye bifite umumaro n'amano utareba hishe mu maso gisa afite umumaro.
Even my legs, they have their use, and even my toes that you can see hidden in the shoes, they also have some role.
Wakagombye rero kuba ufite icyo ukora.
So you should have something that you do.
Ariko hari abantu badakora.
But there are people who don't do.
They are
2, 3, 4 month babies.
They only eat
and they sleep.
If
that's how you are in this church,
that's
the age you have spiritually. You can tick. You're a baby.
Or
you are an adult, a grown
up. A
child who is grown up, they have to do certain things.
That
is also some kind of food.
So
if you don't eat that kind of food,
then
you have malnutrition.
If you
don't do anything but you enjoy the word.
Every
time you feed on the word and you congratulate the pastor for giving you a good
word. He
just wants to eat sweet potatoes all day long and you have malnutrition but you still look big. Because there are some other types of food that you don't
eat.
Now this part has to be strengthened.
In Revelation
chapter 3, Jesus talked about another type of food. He said, I'm on the door, I'm
knocking.
Whoever hears my voice and open, I will enter in his house and will dine with him.
That
is another type of food that is very important.
When
Jesus started his ministry in the wedding in
Cana,
he shared with them. He had
food.
And the Bible said they believed in him.
When you have
that type of relationship with Jesus, learning to commune with him,
eat with him, you
give him time and say, Jesus, it's you and I in this.
That's
when you get to know him.
That's
when you get to know him.
Even more
than what you have received in church.
One
day the disciples were walking on the road to Emmaus.
Jesus
walked with them, but they didn't recognize him.
But when
he started breaking bread while they were sharing,
their
eyes were opened.
Their
eyes were opened.
In that
fellowship with Jesus, while you eat with
him, you
know how you give him time, not in the church programs, but your personal thing.
That's
when he will teach you things that you cannot learn here.
That's
when your eyes will open up. Another time,
the disciples
were locked in a certain place. It was after Jesus' resurrection because they were afraid.
Jesus
entered the place they were into.
Thomas,
and Thomas said, I can't accept that it's him.
And others
say he's a ghost.
He asked
them, don't you have food? Do you have some food? They had fish. He took fish and he ate that fish.
They
said, he's not a ghost, he's a real human being.
And
they stopped their unbelief.
All
those things that you doubt, yet you're a Christian,
what
will take those things away is your communion with Jesus.
I will
enter into his house and we'll dine together.
So
they stopped their unbelief.
And
they said, it's real, he's risen.
And in those
40 days after his
resurrection,
he found them on the sea.
They
had spent the whole night without catching any fish.
He
asked them, dear children, do you have some food?
That
is in John. You need to read that for yourself.
You're
going to eat that for yourself.
And
after they came out of the waters, they found that he had roasted fish and he had made bread and they shared with him.
And then
he gave Peter a mission.
He said,
feed my lamb.
Do
this and do that.
bamaze gusangira.
That was after sharing food with him.
Impamvu Yesu ntacyara kubwira.
The reason why Jesus hasn't told you anything yet.
Ushaka nibyo wakora ukabibura.
And sometimes you don't even know what to do.
Nta gusangira nawe.
You don't eat with him.
Mu ndyo yawe hari ikibura.
And there is something lacking in your food or in your diet. Malnutrition.
Subiramo ngo
malnutrition. Malnutrition.
Malnutrition.
Malnutrition.
Kandi ibiryo bihari.
And yet food is available.
Uzi kurwara bwaki ibiryo bihari.
Do you know having malnutrition yet food is available?
Ibyo ni byo biryo rero bizakomeza irishyira hamwe.
So that is the food that is going to strengthen this partnership.
Noneho rigiye kubohora uyu mutima.
Now it's going to deliver this heart.
Uyu mutima nawo ugomba gucungurwa.
This heart has to be redeemed.
Bibiliya ibyita the salvation of the soul.
The Bible calls it the salvation of the soul.
Lo salut de l'âme.
The salvation of the soul.
Hano, how are your salvation of the spirit?
Here there was the salvation of the spirit.
Now.
Iri shyirahamwe rigomba gusenyuka. This association has to be broken.
Uyu mutima ukabohoka.
And the heart has to be set free.
Uyu mubiri.
And this body.
Ufite akamaro.
It is useful.
Ariko ugategereza igihe impanda izavugira.
But it will wait for the time the trumpet will sound.
Cyangwa ugategereza izuka ry'abapfuye.
Or the resurrection of the bodies.
Kuko ni umubiri w'ibyaha.
Because it is a body of sin.
Ni umubiri w'intege nke.
It is a body of weakness.
Wakozwe mu gitaka.
It was made out of dust.
Tuzahabwa umubiri mushya.
And will be given new bodies.
Nituzuka.
At the resurrection.
Nk'uwo Yesu yari afite.
Just like the body Jesus had.
Tujye duca mu nkuta tutiriwe tunyura mu nzu.
And then we'll be able to go through walls without having to necessarily go through doors.
Nuko Imana ibishaka.
This is how God wants it.
Ishyirahamwe rikaba riruzuye.
And then the partnership or the association will be complete. What does this person bring here?
Azanye ubushake bwe.
He brings his will.
Ubushake bwe bugomba gukorwaho.
The will has to be touched.
Akumvira Imana.
And for him to obey God.
Amabwiriza ava hano.
And the instruction comes from there.
Agaca mu mwuka wawe.
And it goes through your spirit.
Ariko uyu ni ufite ubwenge.
But he's the one who has the mind.
No, ntagakoresha ubwenge bwe ngo abisobanukirwe.
And then he will use the mind to understand.
Akaba renewed in his mind.
And his mind will have to be renewed.
Lo renouvellement de l'intelligence.
The renewing of the mind.
Ukagira intelligence renouvelée.
And you have a mind that is renewed.
Ukagira ubwenge bwuzuye ijambo ry'Imana.
And you have a mind that is full of the word of God.
Ijambo rya Kristo ribe muri mwe rigwiriye.
May the word of God abide in you abundantly.
Iryo ni ijambo ry'Imana ribidutegeka.
Abide in you abundantly.
Ubushake bwe bugakorwaho.
And his will be touched.
Akajya yishimira.
And he will enjoy.
Iby'Imana ishaka.
What are the desires or the will of God?
Abefeso 6:6.
Ephesians chapter 6 verse 6.
Mumere nk'imbata za Kristo.
Say, be like slaves of Jesus.
Mukore iby'Imana ishaka mubivanye ku mutima.
Do the will of God from your hearts.
Gukora iby'Imana ishaka ubivanye ku mutima.
Doing the will of God from your heart.
Reka nkwereke iyo umutima wawe mu bushake bwawo utavugura uko bimera.
Let me tell you how it is when your heart has not been renewed.
Garuka hano tukwitize gato.
Come back here, we are going to use it.
Araryamye.
She sleeps.
Akavura karagwa.
And then rain falls.
Katari kenshi ariko gafatika.
Not so much, but some rain.
Ni igihe cyo kujya mu iteraniro.
It's time to go to the service.
Ubushake buravuga ngo.
The will says.
Oya, imvura yaguye sinjyayo.
No, it is raining, I'm not going there.
Kame mu birumvikana.
It's obvious.
Akakomeza akaryama.
And they will continue to sleep.
Impamvu abonye igize nini cyane.
And the reason that is there has been amplified.
Hashira iminota 40 aryamye.
40 minutes after he's sleeping.
Kandi imvura ntiyahise.
And the rain didn't stop.
Umuntu akamuhamagara ari Kabuga.
Someone calls him from Kabuga.
Ngo ngwino nkwishyure bya bihumbi.
Say, come and I repay you the 600,000 that I owe you. Let me tell you. They go like a bullet very fast. Tells the motorbike guy. I'll pay you double. But accept to go in under the rain and let us go to
Kabuga.
What is that strength that is going to Kabuga? Where is it coming from? In the rain. The heart responded to that. What the heart responds to, you find the strength to do that. That's why God wants to deliver your heart, to set free your heart, so that you might be a slave of Christ, doing the will of God from your heart. And in doing the will of God from your heart, the instructions that come from Jesus you have united with, they are not going to find the hindrance of you refusing to do that. There are so many things God can use this church to do. You know, I'm not used to preaching to this number of people. It's like I'm on Amahoro Stadium. So I think that you have so many things to do. But I know that there is one big obstacle.
The will of your heart.
The will of your heart is a big obstacle. Because the will of your heart is what will cause the will of God to be done here on earth. And the prayer of our Father in heaven,
it
says, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. While Jesus was on earth, he did the will of God. He didn't hinder the will of God. And then he said, as my Father sent me, the same way I'm sending you, I'm leaving you this work. And he left. So if you don't do it, the kingdom of God is not going to expand. Omega is not going to expand. He respects you. But remember one thing. God has 1,000 years to do whatever he wants. But you have very few years. You can even estimate how many years you have left. That means if you don't allow him to do what he wants to you in your time, he has 1,000 years, so he will wait and use others. But you have lost. The Bible says that David did the will of God during his time. During his time, in other languages, they say during his generation. You only serve in one generation. You won't live in two generations. You know, tomorrow by this time, your time of living will have decreased of 24 hours. That's why the Bible tells us to save time. There is a woman who was called Mary. She anointed Jesus with oil. Jesus, he was still alive before death. And when they saw how Jesus had praised her, they went and prepared for the oil. But then Jesus had to die at some point. They said, it's okay, let us go and anoint his body while he's dead. But they missed one day because of the Sabbath. They had to observe their religious traditions. And when they got there with their oil, he was already risen. They didn't manage to do what they had planned to. They were late. 10 virgins went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them, they entered with the bridegroom. And 5 others, they found that they didn't have enough oil. And they went to shops to buy oil. When they came, by the time they came, they had oil and they were still virgins. They were still virgins, that's the Bible term, and they had oil. But they entered midnight. The other virgins, they came at 3.
The issue of time.
It was the issue of time.
Rero ibyo udakoze uyu munsi wagombaga kubikora.
So whatever you don't do today that you're supposed to do.
Ugatinda.
And you delay.
Nibyo bizakwita une vierge folle.
That is what is going to qualify you as a foolish virgin.
Vierge folle usize mu Kinyarwanda ni isugi yasaze.
A foolish virgin that is the explanation they're fools.
Niba udakora ngo wumvire ukore ibyo wakagombye gukora iki gihe.
If you don't obey and do what you're supposed to do today.
Uri isugi turabyemera.
True, you're a virgin. But you're a foolish virgin.
Rero dukore iby'Imana ishaka tubivanye ku mutima.
So let us do the will of God from our hearts.
Uyo nicyo cyo kumvira tuvuga.
That is the obedience we are talking about.
Uyu waje kwifatanya nawe ni ufite amakuru yose.
This person you came to unite with is the one who has all the information.
Uwifatanya n'umwami Yesu.
Whoever unites with the Lord Jesus.
Ababaye umwuka umwe nawe.
Is one spirit with him.
Ariko wibuke uruhare rwawe.
But remember your role.
Ni wewe ufunga kandi ugafunga.
You're the one who closes and who opens.
Ubushake buri muri wowe.
Your will, the will is in you.
Mukaroti yavuye Sodomu aseta ibirenge atabishaka.
The wife of Lot, she left Sodom, she didn't want.
Ntabwo yageze yaje.
And she didn't arrive where she was going. The Israelites, they left Egypt unwillingly, but they didn't reach where they were going because the will had not been touched yet. I want to end.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Kumvira.
Obedience.
Ufite iki gihe cyo kumvira ntabwo ufite igihe kizaza.
You have this time to obey, you don't have the time to come.
Ubuzima bwacu bukoreshwa rimwe gusa ni nka papier mushwari.
Our life, it is used once, it's like this tissue paper.
Rero utabikoze iki gihe urimo muri iki gihe Imana iguhaye.
If you don't do it now in this season that God has given you,
it will be too late.
Bizaba byatinze cyane, uzawakererewe. You will be a foolish virgin. Let me see how I can conclude in the right way. The benefits of uniting with the Lord Jesus. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 6 that the body is not for immorality, but it is for the Lord. For us, it is self-evident. We feel that our bodies belong to the Lord. But the Bible says, but the Lord is also for the body. The Lord is for the body.
You
see, this body has been promoted. The body has been promoted. The Lord is for the body. Means he's going to strengthen you. Even though you might be in ill health, he's going to enable you to complete the work. He's going to give you the strength.
Amen.
Amen.
Timoteo yararwaraguraga.
So Timothy, he was in ill health.
Ariko ntibyamuje kurangiza umurimo.
But it didn't prevent him from completing the work. Because the Lord is for the body.
Umwami ni
umubiri. The Lord is for the body.
Iyo ni inyungu nziza cyane.
And that is one benefit. Second point.
Hano niho hari imbaraga.
This is where we find strength.
Umwuka wawe azuzura imbaraga.
And your spirit will be full of strength.
Umwuka wawe azuzura imbaraga.
Your spirit will be empowered.
No, no, ntitwaha umwuka w'ubwoba.
And we're not giving even a spirit of fear.
Twaha uw'imbaraga.
But we're given a spirit of power.
Iyo umwuka wawe udafite imbaraga.
When your spirit is powerless.
Ngiye kukwereka indicators.
Let me show you some indicators.
Ibi byerekana.
That is going to show you. You can't pray for a certain request and bring it to an end. You'll be discouraged very quickly. Many of you have a very long list of prayer requests that you have stopped praying for. Because you no longer have the energy to pray for that. The same way you might have some power just to charge your phone and then they ask you to power this whole house. You have no energy.
umwuka w'intege nyu ubwirwa no gusengera ibyifuzo ntibirangire.
So what shows you the indicator of powerlessness in your spirit? You don't pray for the request up to the end so that you might have an answer, yes or no.
Umwuka w'intege nke,
spirit that is weak,
urangwa no gutinya.
Is characterized by fear.
Pastor yaguha umurimo.
And when the pastor gives you a responsibility,
you say, Pastor, sorry, this one I can't.
And yet you've been here 10 years studying, learning.
He's not asking you
to do it even in the whole church, just one cell.
Go to the cell, do this.
Please tell Norman.
No.
That is a spirit of weakness. But yet you have the reserve of power. Whoever unites with the Lord Jesus becomes one spirit with him.
Yes, Hashim.
Praise be to Jesus. As the heart is being transformed in obedience to God, filling your mind with the word of God, your heart is renewed.
Ni process.
It's a process.
Nzabaha umwuka mushya, nzabaha n'umutima mushya.
I'll give you a new heart and I'll give you a new spirit.
Amasezerano yaje mu ibahasha imwe.
Those two promises came in one envelope, in the same envelope. That is in Jeremiah.
Nzabaha umwuka mushya.
I'll give you a new spirit and I'll give you a new heart.
Wa mutima mushya.
That new heart.
Uko uyu mutima ugenda uhinduka.
As it is being transformed.
Uhinduka umutima ushaka.
It will become a heart that seeks God.
Zaburi ravuga ngo nkuko imparaka zishaka ifite inyota yo gushaka amazi. Niko umutima wanjye ugushaka.
As the deer pants for the water, the same way my heart is longing after you.
Umutima ushaka Imana.
A heart that longs after God.
Iyo umutima wawe ushaka Imana.
When your heart is longing after God.
Ugasanga igihe cyo gusenga gihuye n'igihe cyo kureba Rayon Sports.
And you realize that the time of prayer coincides with the time of Rayon Sports going to watch the game.
Cyangwa gasobanuye.
Oh, those movies that we like. You choose to pray. Physically speaking. When you're hungry, no one will come and tell you, you're hungry, please. No one will come to tell you. You know you're thirsty, let us give you a drink.
Mfite inyota yo kujya gusenga.
Do you feel your heart telling you I'm thirsty to go and pray?
Niba ibyo bitajya bikubaho.
If that doesn't happen to you.
Uribaza ahantu uri mu buryo bw'umwuka.
Then you need to imagine how you are in the spirit.
Umutima ushaka Imana.
A heart that seeks after God.
Indi nyungu y'umutima uhindutse.
Another benefit of a heart that has been transformed.
Uhimbazimana.
It becomes a heart that praises God.
Iname ki exalter o Seigneur.
A heart that exalts the Lord.
Ayo magambo ni Maria nyina wa Yesu wayavuze.
Those are the words that Mary, the mother of Jesus, said.
Yaravuze ngo mon âme exalte le Seigneur.
He said, my soul magnifies the Lord.
Ai mon esprit se réjouit.
And my spirit rejoices.
Umutima uhimbaza Imana.
A heart that magnifies the Lord, exalts the Lord, and the spirit that rejoices in the Lord.
Naho Imana ishaka kukugeza.
This is where God wants to take us.
Worship team, mbibwirire.
Worship team, let me tell you.
Muratubwira ngo muhaguruke muhimbaze Imana.
Praise God, rejoice in God in your
heart.
If they have not given their hearts to God,
there is something wrong in them.
Whatever you do is going to be difficult, it's going to be mechanical because there's something wrong in them. Because it all comes from a heart that praises God. And where did Mary get that heart from? She said, I'm the servant of the Lord, may his will be done. Have you ever signed for that? You know the time you got saved, and you know the time you got
baptized,
and the time you became a member of Omega Church. But do you know the time you consecrated yourself to the Lord, saying, I surrender myself to you? Why? Because of two things. Salvation is like marriage.
2 Corinthians 11:12.
In these versions, they say,
ndabafuhira nkuko Imana ibafuhira.
I'm jealous of you, the jealousy of God.
Kuko nabatanze mumeze nk'umugeni wirinze ngo nzabashyingira umukumwe ari we Kristo.
Because I gave you as a bride that kept herself pure so that I can wed you to the bridegroom who is Christ.
Agakiza ni mariage.
So salvation is marriage.
Mana yabwiye abagore mu Bibiliya ngo mugandukire abagabo.
The Bible tells women wives to be submitted to their husbands.
Umutima ugandukira Imana wamaze kwiha Imana no kuyigandukira.
A heart that submits to God. Have you ever surrendered yourself to God and submitted to God?
Nta kibazo ufitanye n'Imana.
You don't have any issue with God? Are you at peace with God?
Ndetse ukanga no kubisengera kugira ngo Imana itavaho igira n'iki bikubwiraho.
You know, sometimes you don't even want to pray about it because you don't want God to tell you something on that subject. I don't even want anyone to prophesy about that, that I have
agakiza
to do
ni mariage.
But salvation is a marriage.
Mariage bivuze submission.
And marriage means submission.
Kandi mariage bivuze love,
rukundo. And marriage means love.
We yaragukunze nta kibazo gihari yaragupfiriye.
There is no issue for that.
No, ndetse wowe nk'umugore
but as the wife, did you submit to him? Second point. Salvation is becoming a slave. Romans chapter 6. The Bible says,
ntimuzi ko uwo mwihaye ngo mumubere imbata muri imbata z'uwo nguwo mwihaye.
Don't you know that you're the slaves of the one you gave yourself to be slaves to?
Muri iki gihe nta mbata zikibaho.
Nowadays we no longer have slaves.
Imbata ni umuntu utagira uburenganzira.
But a slave is someone who doesn't have any rights.
Imbata yagira ubuzima bubi iyo shebuja ari mubi.
A slave will have a bad life when the master is a bad person.
Ariko niba databuja Yesu ari mwiza.
But if our master Jesus is good, there is no problem of fearing to be his slaves. Your obedience, it will depend on how you accept to submit to Jesus. And then, accept to be his slave. When you haven't made that step yet, your measure of discipleship will stay at kindergarten, nursery school. Or if you really manage to go far, you go up to primary school level.
Yes, Hashim.
Praise be to Jesus.
No, neho rero.
Now.
Kuko turabo yaremye.
Because we are those he created.
Are
for good works.
Ni uzakuyobora imirimo uzakora.
He's the one who's going to lead
ni
you.
Ni uzaguhimbaraga.
Going to do and he's the one who's going to supply the
azaguhana amafaranga.
And he's going to give you the resources, the money.
Azaguha ubuzima.
And he's going to give you the health.
Azarinda umubiri wawe.
He's going to protect your body.
Arinde n'umuryango wawe kugisekuruza cy'abana n'abuzukuru.
Up to grandchildren and great grandchildren.
Iyo mirimo rero wako.
Now, those works you have done under the leadership of the Spirit, those are the ones you'll be rewarded for in heaven. Those are the only works you'll be rewarded for in heaven. If MTN gave me money to sell cards, and then I go to Byumba to plant cassava, and I say that now the cassava is the one that has
price.
It will be very difficult for me. It will be difficult for me. But unfortunately, MTN will take me to jail. So be careful not to be thrown in jail. God bless you, beloved. Submit your heart to God. Surrender your heart to God. And know that the one you have united with has everything. Please clap for them as they go and we'll come to an end.
Amen.
Amen. So how are we going to end?
Conclude.
Pastor made it simple for me. Give me 3-4 minutes and I'm going to give you a testimony. I really love that.
Yes.
It means yes. I was a teacher in
public schools.
Public schools.
Imana impamagarira kubwiriza.
And God called me to go preach the gospel.
Ariko icyo gihe byari bigoye.
At that time it was very difficult.
Byasabaga kureka akazi nkajyaga kwiga ishuri rya Bibiliya.
I had to leave my job and go for the Bible school.
Yewe numwe mu bantu bo mu miryango yari yanshakiye akazi karyoshye muri UN.
And one of my family members had got me a very good job in UN.
Byari muri 1994.
That was in 1994.
Intambara na genocide bivuyemo.
Just after the genocide.
Ukurikije ubwenge bw'abantu.
If you try to think about it logically,
nari nkoze iby'ubupfu kwanga akazi keza nkajya kuba umubwiriza w'ubutumwa.
I had done a foolish thing to let go of that job and to go become a preacher of the word.
Amahirwe nagize.
Now the good thing that happened to me.
Ibi mbigisha nari mbizi usibye ko ntari nzi kubyigisha nkuko mbyigisha.
I knew this I'm teaching you about, but I didn't know how to teach about it like I did.
Nari nzi ko ngomba kumvira Imana.
I knew that I had to obey God.
Nuko mpitamo kumvira Imana.
And I chose to obey God.
Iyo bigenze gutyo umuryango wawe niwe uwa mbere uguhagurukira.
And when that happens, your family will be the first one to stand against you. But never trade anything against having Jesus as your friend.
Nuko rero umuntu bw'Imana bwaramfashije.
So now the grace of God came to me and helped me.
Nuko ntangira kuba pastor actually.
And I became a pastor.
Mucyaro.
In the rural areas.
Niga kubwiriza ubutumwa.
And I learned to preach the gospel.
Muri icyo gihe.
And in that time.
Niho nagize umutwaro ukomeye.
That's when I had a great burden.
Wo kwibaza ngo ariko ubundi umuntu akura gute mu buryo bw'umwuka.
Of asking myself, how does one grow spiritually?
Nizihe spiritual dynamics zituma umuntu akura mu mwuka bigenda.
What are the spiritual dynamics of spiritual growth?
Nuko rero kuko nabikoragamo.
Now because I was working in that.
Natangiye kubyiga no kubitekerezaho cyane.
I started learning about that and reflecting and studying on that.
Amashuri ya Bibiliya yararangiye.
I ended the Bible school.
Diploma.
I had a diploma.
Nyuma y'imyaka 5 muri ubwo buzima.
And 5 years later, living that life.
Imana ingarura muri ka kazi ko kwigisha nari narataye.
God brought me back to that job of being a teacher that I had left.
Nuko noneho nza nigisha mu ishuri rya Bibiliya.
But I came as a teacher in the Bible school.
Kuko ukunda ubugingo bwazabubura ariko utita ku bugingo bwazabugarurirwa.
Those who love their life, they will lose it, but those who don't love their lives, it will be given back to them.
Mviyo ngiyo nkaza gukora kwigisha muri Bible school I Kigali.
So when I came to teach in that Bible school in Kigali,
akazi ka UN kari kararangiye kera.
That UN job had ended long ago.
Kuko rero numviye Imana.
Now because I obeyed God.
Iyo myaka 5 nkayikoresha mu kwiga uko bashinga amatorero n'uko bafasha abakirisitu.
And I used 5 years learning how to plant churches, how to help Christians.
Niyo mpamvu ndi hano.
That's why I'm here.
Niyo mpamvu ndi hano.
That's why I'm here.
Niyo mpamvu ndi hano ngo ngire umumaro.
That's why I'm here so that I can be useful to someone.
Ngeze inaha.
Now when I arrived here.
Kuko Imana yabonaga mbizi ariko ntashobora kubyigisha.
Because God saw that I knew that but I couldn't teach that.
Imana ishakira abantu bandihira scholarship niga kaminuza za theology.
God got me people to give me a scholarship and I went for theological classes.
Yes, kuko amafaranga nayayo.
Because money belongs to him.
Uronda bizi kandi mbasha kubyigisha.
Now I know it and I can teach it.
Ariko urugendo rurakomeje.
But the journey continues.
Uburundi mu mirimo Imana yaneguriye kera ngo nzayigendere.
Now I'm doing the works that God had prepared for me in advance.
Ibyo pastor yavuze nibyo mbikora mbikunze. Nuko ntazi cyakunda namusengerera kuba yamfashije kuza gukora umurimo hano.
You know what pastor said is true. I love what I'm doing and if I knew what she like I would do it for her because she gave me a platform to do it.
Kubera ko ibiryo by'umwuka ni ugukora imirimo.
Because spiritual food is also doing the works. Now I'm fed.
Ndimo kurya.
I'm feeding. I'm eating.
Ubwo rero ibyo nibyo tugomba gukomeza.
So this is what you have to continue.
Nubundi ndacyasenga Imana.
I'm still praying.
Nkayibaza ngo Yesu, what next?
Asking Jesus, what's next?
Niki ushaka?
What do you want?
Umuhanzi umwe yaravuze ngo.
There is one singer who said.
Ngira icyo ushaka mwami.
Tell me what you want from me.
Ngira icyo ushaka.
Tell me what you want from me. That the singer said that. That is a good prayer.
Imana rero ibahe umugisha.
So God bless you.
Umwuka wera abashoboze gufata ibyemezo bikwiriye.
May the Holy Spirit enable you to take the right decisions.
Naho utaha.
And see you next time.
가외란다 궁녀 대회 위로 간세 무리제 운이기세 운민들의 운이여버리 왜 우리 양계도세 계속구샤카 무카웨라 가웨라 드림 안 이래 가웨라